Yeah, guys, we have another Viva L on the channel, so I'm pretty excited for that stack sound alone, you know, and that lift. That too is like a combo, man, on its own. It's liquor. So yeah, hope you guys enjoy it. So as well as I thank you to everyone for subscribing. We hit 11,000. That's past 11,000 now. Sure. Yeah. So we're growing. And yeah, I appreciate it a lot. So yeah. Before we go on, please do like, comment and subscribe on this video. And yeah, enjoy. So yeah, what's your name?
Robin. Robin.
Yeah, so we have Robin here. This was another spur of the moment review, yeah. So we actually got each other on the road once, yeah. Yeah. And we greeted each other and then that's where it all started. So it was quite unplanned. Like, I just came from work now and like now we're doing this. So yeah, I'm pretty excited. So Robin's gonna take us through his car and his story behind his car. So take it away.
Okay, so yeah, I have a 1998 Sable. Car is recently sprayed. It was a friend of mine's car previously. Yo, this car I have like a long history to it actually. I'm the third owner of this car. It was first Slowie's car. Everybody probably knows Slowie.
Serious?
Yeah, this was Slowie's car first.
This car has a history. Yo.
And then from there it became my friend Josh. Josh is probably watching. Yeah, this was his car. He spent a lot of money on the car engine wise. The car is still like the bottom is still stock, the engine is balanced. Basically this is my daily car. Car don't have no problems, no oil leaks, no water leaks.
Get in and go,
VVL. Yeah, a lot of people talk about bearing knocks and stuff. I never ever had like bad experiences like that. I daily drive my car, all day in the lift, no problem.
Just to get oil, no?
It's all oil and water. That's very important, like in the morning before I start the car and then just check the oil and idle the car for like 15, not even 15, like maybe 5 minutes, yeah? No? Just to get the oil liquor on the level and then I drive the car.
So how long do you have this car?
This one I have about 2 months now. This one I have 2 months, yeah.
I'm assuming this is not the only one that you had before.
No, I had this is my sixth one.
So you were innocent coupe.
I had the first one. I had it was basically like I bought the car from also a friend. It was like a friend thing. So I don't know. Like all my friends is just they're keeping me in the listen game. They don't want me to get any other car. So whenever there's a listen for sale, my friends will tell me, look here, there's a car for you and whatever.
So you don't stick long to a car when you get bored of it, you just sell it, get the new one.
Yes.
The 5 others that you had, was that also VVL?
The 4 was VVL, the 1 was a DE.
How would you compare it to this one?
I was actually getting to that. The first one that I got, that car was, I won't say immaculate, but yeah, it was to a level, like I can say that car, if you walk past, you must look at it. And then I always wanted a car like that, on that car's level. And then each and every one I got, I compared it to that car. I didn't get anything like that car until I got this one. This is basically the one that is the same like that car, like on the level like that one. Yeah, so that's why I think I'm gonna keep this one for the time. Okay, so I try to keep the engine bay as stock as I can. As you can see, the aircon is still on the car. The battery bracket, I must put the battery bracket still back on. It's actually done. I was about to do that. Everything else is simple. There's no water or oil leaks on the car. Nothing. Everything is here like it's supposed to be.
Plan on running a stack?
Soon, yes. No? Definitely out of the headline.
Nah, but this bay looks lekker.
Shut up.
It's very rare that you see a VVL with a cone filter nowadays, no?
Yo. Everybody's running stacked.
Everyone, yo. Yes, yes. But it's done nicely. Who done your tapered cover for you?
We
see that
was
his car. He's probably watching now. Oh, us through the motor. Like, obviously we all know it's VVL, but like, just take us more in depth.
Okay. Yo, I don't really want to go very much into detail, but no. The car have a head job. There's cams, OEM N1 cams in the car. I don't want to talk power figures. I have power mods issue in the car. The car has currently got launch control. That's also like, I don't know, some people say maybe it's a mod or I don't know.
Yeah, there's definitely a mod, man.
So yeah, that's what's done to the car. Nothing else much.
No block or
no block is stock.
So N1 cams, the basics.
Just the top basically that's touched, yeah. The bottom
and
is
gonna... gearbox ratios? Nothing.
Nothing.
No.
Nothing much.
LSD?
No LS.
Yo, no you don't want to give much away about the car.
No more Primera gearbox.
Yo, we're gonna have to dig it out of you. But yeah, like you would say, it's probably Cape Town stock.
Cape Town stock, yeah.
Other than that, induction, exhaust.
What? Yo, there's not even really induction. You can see there's still a cone filter on the car in front. I basically tried to keep it as, I won't say standard as possible, but tried to keep it like basic, man. I didn't want to go with
plus.
I didn't want to go with the stack because, you know, petrol meters. Like, yo. I daily drive the car, I had cars with stacks on and I'm driving off to the sound all day. I want to be there 7,000 just to hear the stack. So daily I put the normal filter on. I didn't put the stack on this car. I would actually like to hear the car sound of the stack.
Any future mods on the motor?
Yo, at this point, I don't know.
Money.
I don't know what could be next. It's like, I don't want to scratch where it's not itching, basically.
Yeah.
Like,
you're happy with the power figures now.
I'm happy like the car is now. I don't want to scratch at the bottom and then I end up failing. You know, a lot of people can't really build up VVLs, to tell you the truth. People build up a car and it's either bearing knock car and the car drive for a week, 2 weeks and the car is motor failed. And everybody get to hear the story of VVL is cuck. So I don't want to be in that trap. That's why I prefer rather like stock. If I do pitter, it's rather on the top. I don't work with the crank, I don't touch nothing.
But maybe give us like a hint, man. What figures you're running? Around how much?
160 odd.
Tuned and everything, huh?
The car is tuned, yeah, by Z-Line. Respect. Yo, that man, tops.
Yeah. Because I remember Mario's car was also tuned by him.
Yeah.
The one that had done, the maroon one.
Yes. Very good for him, man. No? Mario.
Yeah, if you guys didn't check that one out, I'll put the card up there. It was like one of my first ones that I done,
I remember that. I remember that car actually driving. Yeah. I think it was his one. Or
it was that one. Yeah. And then there was a white one also.
I was actually like up to date with what is happening. It's just now recently that the car has kept me very busy, so I wasn't still like following much. But I mean, okay, so when I got the car wasn't really looking like this. Everybody that had the car spent money on the motor and everything else besides, like, it didn't get to that point yet, man. Like, every time they sort out this of the car, that of the car, and then it didn't get to the point where they sorted, like, the paint work out, and then I had the car. My friend actually had the car sprayed, and then I got the car from him, Josh, and then I just basically sprayed the bumper, the lip, color coded it, sprayed the fin, put stickers on the car, make the car to my liking. Yeah, the car didn't have ABS or so on, and it was a tough mission finding ABS to get the car.
No. Especially now the reps also coming.
Yeah, yo. Plus, I don't also like reps.
Definitely.
I wanted OEM, so it was a bit of a mission to get everything original again.